Okay, folks, crappy day. It's cloudy, rained all night, pretty eerie outside, really chilly, so I'm not going to be grilling, even though I got this stuff on the grill, technically speaking. Anyway, the purpose of this particular video is I picked up some of this new Kingsford heavy-duty non-stick aluminum grilling foil, and I want to show you guys a quick little comparison to the old standby, the Reynolds wrap foil. Now, this foil, every time I do my onions, you guys watch my videos, you know I love grilling onions. When I do my onions, this stuff is really thin, flimsy. So what I do is I double it up. Sometimes I actually have to stop, move everything around, and triple this foil up. See how easy it crumbles? So Home Depot had this under $5. That's not sale price. That's regular price. $4.97, I think it was. Now this stuff, it's only 45 square feet compared to 75 on this one. But when you double it up, you're already cutting this foil in half. And then when you triple it up, see where I'm going with this? So you actually save money by going with this more expensive foil with the smaller square footage. And non-stick. So, now this stuff, much thicker, and it doesn't crumble nearly as easy. So, could do some tater tots later. Might grill an onion, grill this onion, but we're doing Curly's pulled pork barbecue sandwiches. It's a crappy day, and it takes way too long to do this stuff by hand. So I got this. We're going to make pulled pork sandwiches, dice up these onions, maybe grill these on the new foil, and they'll make a batch of tater tots. So that's on the agenda. So yeah, big difference. Plus this is 18 inches long. You see the big difference when you put them end to end here. Cut myself. But yeah, you get the idea. But anyway, I just want to show you guys that. That's it for right now. And rub-a-dub-dub. Later on, it'll be time to grub. Yellow Groove. It's a Weber. All right, I'm back. I left something out here. I'm going to show you guys some of these tater tots I got. They were sold out. They didn't have any of the Orida ones, tater tots. So I got these tater bites, which I've had these before, and they're pretty much the same thing. And what I haven't decided yet is if I'm going to deep fry them. Remember, you guys, you saw my videos. If you follow my vids, you know I got that new deep fryer. But in the oven, 450 for 20 to 24 minutes. But when you deep fry them, 3 to 5 minutes. Or you can pan fry them. Or I got that new foil. I can season them up real good and wrap them in foil and cook them right here on the old grill. Like I could do that. I don't know, there's so many options. I love these cast iron grates. I don't know if I told you guys this, but these grates reverse. There's actually two individual grates here. And the bottom side is flat, so if you want to do like delicate stuff like asparagus or fish, you know, that kind of stuff, seafood, it lays better pretty much because you don't get these sharp points on the top. But anyway, yeah, tater bites. I'm going to be doing these with the pulled pork barbecue sandwiches. Yeah, I know it's not homemade pulled pork, but man, you know what? When you guys done that, you know what goes into making it. Like I said, it's a crappy day, and I don't feel like going in here for 3, 4, 5 hours doing this stuff or even more. Anyway, that's it for now. I'll add this to the previous video. And I rub-a-dub-dub. Later on, it'll be time to grub. Yellow Groove out. Catch you on the rebound.